One of the strangest substances to be found on planet Earth is a material that was once thought to be impossible outside of the very cold outer solar system. That was until oceanic deposits of it were found here on Earth in the 1960s. It's methane clathrate, or also often termed methane hydrate or flammable ice. This substance occurs where methane is trapped in the presence of water under high pressure, producing a material in a kind of ice. Now, these deposits are known to be relatively common, and indeed are a reservoir for extracting natural gas. But within the study of methane hydrate deposits came a surprising revelation that these environments can host life under very specific conditions, making for one of the most extreme environments for life on Earth currently known. Within the clathrates can be found bubbles of water and oil that were found to host living microorganisms. The finding was actually accidental. The researchers were studying the material for another purpose when someone noticed odd, discolored spheroids or bubbles within the methane hydrate that didn't look quite right. After further study, it was found to be microbial life, existing in very unusual high-pressure conditions and at very low temperatures. Life's resiliency surprises yet again indeed, but there is an astrobiological component to this finding. Methane hydrate on Earth is partially a product of life, produced when microbes consume organic materials within the ocean. This opens up the possibility for life on exoplanets that otherwise might not have been considered good candidates for life. For example, cold worlds, such as ice shell worlds in our own solar system, like Europa, that might host unusual habitats for life within certain types of ices. This might be a type of environment where entire ecosystems exist within a tiny bubble of habitability, frozen within a matrix of material like methane hydrate, but perhaps nowhere else on that entire exoplanet. This opens up questions about what the origins of such life might be, or how changing planets might continue to support life as habitability declines. Unfortunately, finding this kind of life off Earth is a long shot. Such life would be essentially impossible to detect at a distance. You'd have to head for the exoplanet or outer solar system body and take a close look at its ices to find anything, which seems a far future endeavor, but it goes to show that the more we learn about just where life can exist, the broader the palette for its existence seems to get, at least at the microbial level. As an aside, methane clathrates are interesting for other reasons. One is that they have been implicated in past mass extinctions here on Earth. The idea is that if the clathrates release methane due to oceanic disturbance, then it would wreak havoc on the climate and oceans due to methane being a greenhouse gas. This hypothesis, however, has lost steam in recent years, and now seems unlikely due to studies of isotope ratios in rock deposits from those periods. But they may still affect Earth's atmosphere, at least more recently. Periods of warming during the last ice age suggest that methane release may have played a role, at least in some of them. And it's even possible that beneficial effects, at least for life on Earth, may have been due to clathrates. They may also have been involved in the sudden warming that occurred at the end of the hypothesized snowball Earth period, where much of the planet may have frozen over sometime before about 630 million years ago. What effects methane clathrates may have on future extinctions or climate events on Earth is unclear. Thanks for listening. I'm futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently being a science fiction author because that's what I am. Yes, folks, there's a new book in the works, and more content on both this channel and Event Horizon coming this month. Stay safe and be well, and be sure to check out my already finished books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.